Hi everyone, and welcome to my TEE T-Log. And today I've come to escape the sounds of roadworks that are happening in my street at this current time. Because if I spent all day in my house with the sounds of drilling and soaring, it'll just drive me crazy. But I'm here in a place called Ramsbottom, or in other words, a male sheep's arse. Or for the American Canadian viewers watching this, it roughly translated, it means male sheep's butt. Now, I was thinking, what could be interesting about this place? Well, I have found some information that could be quite interesting. Starts. What does this place mean? And then I find this is where I currently am. I am in Marketplace. And this is what this place is behind me, as you can see. And if we look to the side here, it either looks like a tipped over vase or a very big football trophy. Some other information. This place looks interesting. The East Lancashire Railway. I think I may go there as well. Have a look at that. But there was one thing I was actually interested in, actually. The Peel Tower. You could see that from across the M66 motorway toward Manchester. So Peel Tower looks to be interesting. I'll have a look at that. And did you know, actually, if you've been watching Wallace and Gromit as a kid, you will notice that Wallace's crush is actually called Wendelline Ramsbottom. So, and Nick Park, coming from Preston, kind of named a character after a town in Lancashire. The surname anyway of it is kind of intriguing. If you want to find what episode of Wallace and Gromit that's on, it's on Wallace and Gromit and Close Shave. So join me later, and I think I'll be in the East Lancashire Railway. Oh yes. I think I am in the East Lancashire Railway station, because as you can see, here are all the old steam trains that were usually at this station. And that, to me, looks like the Mallard. Can see it a bit closer. Oh, the Flying Scotsman. No way does that look like the Flying Scotsman. It's more like the mallard. But, yeah, so many steam trains. And look, I think this is the station I'm in. If we walk out here, here is the platform. I am in a platform of East Lancashire, platform 2. Over there says Ramsbottom. Now, when I was here last time, I think, there was actually a steam train. A steam train actually stopped here. And I thought, darn, I should have got my camera. I should have filmed it. I should have filmed the moment when the steam train stopped here. But it didn't. And you can actually smell the steams now. It's really nice, actually. Yeah, that's the signal house. Further along down the track here. You can see how nicely this station is. It's like you're in the 1800s, basically. Look at this teddy bear there. Very patriotic teddy bear. See here these old fashioned signs, which I like, by the way. I do like it, it's very exquisite. I know I'm talking like rarity here, but come on, I've got to admit, these are really nice. This is the East Lancashire Railway station. Join me later, and maybe if I get close enough to the Peel Tower, we could actually walk to it together. So join me then. Oh yes. You know what's the thing about East Lancashire? There are very steepish hills. You know, I mean, okay, that doesn't look very steep, but when you walk them, yeah, it is pretty steep, and East Lancashire is famous for that. You know, if you go to places like Blackburn, Darwin, Worley, here, Ramsbottom, towards Cheshire, it's pretty steep. And I think the Lake District is pretty steep as well. Because, you know, this isn't a flat country. This isn't Holland, okay? Holland is flat. But the UK, we have our mountains. Just like the Rock, you know. The United States has the Rocky Mountains, the Canadians have the Canadian Rocky Mountains, you know. And, well, could be worse. I mean, I could be in New Zealand, where apparently they have the world's steepest hill. And I think it's in Wellington. So, could be wrong. Any New Zealanders watching, leave a comment. I can learn stuff, but at the moment I'm hill walking. It's good exercise. It's kind of like the Eiffel Tower experience, you know, climbing the over 6,000 steps, or is it 1,000? Mum, do you remember that one? So, yeah. So maybe, just maybe, I can get up to Peel Tower. And just right now, I just showed you a very, not very steep hill, but a steep hill. So, talk to me later. As I'm beginning to sound like Princess Celestia roundabout now. With a bit of the Zoe charm. So, to all my subjects of the day, join me later.
Look what I happen to find. English horses. This was just like when I was in Flanders, toward Antwerp. Where is that? Where's the black and white one? Oh, there's one of them. That's the tail, huh? Okay. That to me looks like a stallion. Oh, I don't know. English horses. English horses.
Hello everyone, I am here because we are getting closer to where I was trying to find. I don't know if you've managed to find it on the information back in Market Square in Ramsbottom. That Peel Tower was actually public funded and built in memory of the person who invented the police force, Sir Robert Peel. And I may have to talk loud here because it's quite windy up here, since I'm in the mountain range. I'm on top of a mountain, pretty much. I could be higher, but, you know, that's not why I'm here. The reason why I'm here is because I wanted to have a look at the view that Peel Tower offers. And I've always thought, when I was on the M66 motorway, is what would it be like up there? What would it be like? It looks like a nice little thing. And, you know, I made it a mission, if you will. You know, like a thing on the list. You're right on the list to do with your plans, and coming to it at last. So, Peel Tower is right behind. Here are the views that it offers. Like where that church is, I think. And towards them houses there is Ramsbottom itself. And over here, if we can, I don't know if you can see it. No, it's too foggy. Well, then again, you might do if you look carefully. Generosity, I'm here to show that. Manchester. Generosity, you are the key.
tell that was Manchester. Just for you. Here's the mountainside anyway. Tower.